Hi everyone, it's Paula and I'm here in the Cricut Craft Room today and we're going to be talking about weld, attach, and group, what the differences are and what you use them for. So we're going to hop over to Design Space and get started. Okay, so first thing that we're going to do is we are going to talk about weld. Welding makes it so your image becomes one new complete image. So if we're going to start with some shapes, and if we select a square and a triangle, and let's say we're gonna make a cute little house. So we're gonna set those on top of each other. And there we go, there's our house. But once we hit make it, it takes it away. So it cuts them side by side instead of the triangle on top of the square. One way that we can remedy this is by selecting both of the shapes and clicking on weld. Now you can see that that cut line in the middle from the triangle and the top of the square is no longer there. So if we hit make it now, it is going to cut all as one image. The only way to undo weld in Design Space is using our undo button. So we would click on this and then hit undo, and it takes those two apart again for us. Once a welded image is saved, you will not be able to go back and undo that. You would have to create a different image. Another time that we use weld is when we're cutting out words. So if we add the word hello, we're gonna change this, oops. We're gonna pick a different font. And let's see, we'll try the Alexis. And we're going to change this. It's going to be our cut. So as you can see, this is kind of a scrolly little font and looks like it would be a cursive font. So now we want these to be a little bit closer together and we need them to be welded together so there's no cut lines when you're weeding your vinyl or your iron-on. One way that you can bring your letters closer together is the letter spacing. And you can use the up or down arrows, or you can just pick a number and see how close it gets them. All right, as you can see, our E and our L are very close together, but they aren't all close together. So while this is selected, you can right click and go to ungroup. This is going to make each one of your letters its own image on our layers panel over here. And now you can move each of the letters individually from the other. So we're just going to move those so they're attached and they look like a cute little cursive writing. I suggest working with these when they're larger and then resizing them down to the size that you need so you can make sure that you're getting them all together the way you want them to look. So if we go and highlight all of these, make it a little bit bigger, you can see that my lines here and here are just a touch off. So I'm gonna see if I can, I'm gonna see if I can add those in, add those closer so that they're a little more even. And if it's not perfect, that is okay. Alrighty, put that O back where it belongs. And there you go. So now you can see they're all together, written the way we want them to look. However, from this screen, if we go to make it, it is going to arrange our letters in just the best way that the Design Space feels that it'll fit on the mat to get the most out of your mat. That obviously does not say hello to us. So you are going to want to highlight all of your letters and use weld. That is going to take all these cut lines out. Attach, which is another option for us to use when adding things together, will not take those cut lines away. The only thing that will take the cut lines away is weld. So now when we go to make it, it's going to add all of this together as one cut. The H will be separate because it's the standalone H, but the rest will cut out all together. Okay, now we're gonna talk a little bit about attach. So we're gonna go ahead and take that one off our screen. And now we're going to go to images. All right, we are going to search for some hearts. And as you can see here in Design Space, we have a lot of little heart options, a lot of them, and they're so cute. But we're gonna find something that maybe has two or three hearts all together. Okay, let's do add an S there and see if that gets us our hearts quicker. There we go. All right, so we're going to add this and this, and then we're going to add this. All right, so here we have all of our different hearts. Now, if I'm arranging these, say I want to put these all on a shirt. If I'm arranging these and I want the big heart to be here in the middle, and then I want these little hearts trailing off here to the side, and then I want to take these cute little hearts and put them right in the middle there of the empty cutout heart. This is exactly how I want my image to look. This is exactly how I want it to go onto my, say if I'm making a shirt with iron on, this is exactly how I want it to go on there. However, when I go to make it, it puts the hearts other places. And even these hearts are on a different screen because they were in Design Space as a different color. I want them to be all the same color and all to go in the same spot. So what I'm going to do is highlight all of these and I'm going to attach them. That's going to make them all the same color. And when I go to make it, it is going to leave that all together where I want it to be. So it's going to cut those there. So then I'm not having to place those again when I want to put them on my material. They're already exactly where I want them to be. Okay, so now we're going to talk about group. And when you're grouping or ungrouping something, it basically keeps your images together or your words together on the screen to make it easier for sizing and for how it's going to look, and when you're working with layers to make sure that everything is sized correctly for how you need it. So if we are going to use this heart, and then in red, we're going to say, I love you. We're going to click on this and change that to red. All right. So now, if we resize this to go under our heart, but we need this whole image to be a different size. Now we can highlight it and then make it bigger or smaller, but once we click off of that, now if I try to move something, it moves independently. So what we're going to do is highlight this, and we can use group up here, just click on that. Or if you use right click, you have the option of group or ungroup. So now that this is grouped together, even if I click off of it and I click back, it's still going to be all together. So I can manipulate my size and do different things to it, but when I click make it, it's still going to cut out the way it needs to. It's going to cut out the solid, it's going to cut out the cutout hearts, and then it's going to cut out the I love you, all on their separate colors. Now, if you notice, when we do this, if I were to just hit attach instead of group, it makes everything all the same color. Group is something that we use in Design Space to make sure that we are able to keep our proportions together, we're able to keep our layers together, and that we don't have to individually try to manipulate the size. So now that we've talked about group and weld and attach, you guys are ready to start using more layers, using more images, and combining your words and your phrases together to have your projects look how you have them planned out to look, but the design space does most of the work for you. All right, we are so grateful that you guys were able to join us today and learn about group and weld and attach. And if you have questions about other things, make sure you check out our videos and see if we can help you learn how to use your new Cricut machine even better. Thanks.